have bifurcated this course into five components. The first one is Introduction to Cybersecurity, Basic Principles, Information Assets and Asset Owners. The second one is Cybersecurity Threats with few examples, where do they come from and its remedy. The third one is about mitigating cybersecurity risks and protecting our data through automatic updation of softwares, installation of antiviruses, implementation of cybersecurity policies, and how we secure our infrastructure and implementation of multi-factor authentication also. The fourth one is about how we have to be safe and vigilant while using the devices connected with internet, like emails, online ticket booking, net banking, digital wallets, and also fair knowledge about parenting in digital age and other cybersecurity hygienic measures. The fifth one is about business continuity and disaster recovery. Also, we have included what are the highly demandable jobs available in cybersecurity domain. Now, let us look at what is cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is the process of protecting and recovering devices, networks, and programs from any type of damage, attack, or unauthorized access, or doing and keeping everything online safe. It could be your mobile, your desktop, laptop, tablet, or any devices you connect with internet. Now, let us look at why you need to know about cybersecurity. Hackers and cyber terrorists have lot many opportunities to exploit individuals and large companies. As an individual or as a part of an organization, it has become mandate to learn about cybersecurity. Let us look at what are the areas you have to concentrate as an individual. Safe browsing, using emails, net banking and online ticket booking, while using social media like Facebook and WhatsApp, and when you are using digital wallets also, while playing online games. Also, as a part of an organization, protection of system against viruses, worms, spyware, and other unwanted programs. Protection against data theft, protection of personal information, network, and other resources, minimization of computer downtime, improved data security. Here we will learn what is computer security, information security, and cyber security. What is computer security? Computer security is the protection of computer systems and information from harm, theft, and unauthorized use. Example, login password. Information security is the practice of protecting information from unauthorized access and alteration. It also establishes a set of processes that will protect information assets. Example, mobile number, address, and email ID. Revealing our mobile number, email ID to anyone unnecessarily may invite unnecessary threats in later stage. Cybersecurity is the protection of your computers, networks, programs, and data from unauthorized access or modification. Example, antivirus software, keeping your software up to date. Let's look into the basic principles of information security. Confidentiality, integrity, and availability are the three basic components for the safe utilization, flow, and storage of any information. Confidentiality means something that is secret and is not supposed to be disclosed to unintended people or entities. It also ensures that sensitive information is accessed only by an authorized person and kept away from those not authorized to possess them. For example, when the password of the computer or mobile is correct, then only the user is allowed to log in and use. Allowing anyone without the correct password could harm the data stored inside. This ensures the confidentiality. Other examples are bank account statements and credit card numbers. Integrity ensures information remain accurate, consistent, and not subject to unauthorized modification. Integrity is achieved when the appropriate measures are in place, which ensures communication between the sender and receiver is not intercepted and modified during the transit. For example, when a sender sends data, the receiver must receive the same data as sent by the sender. The content should not get altered during the transit by unauthorized people or any other attacks like session hijacking, man in the middle, etc. We will cover those topics when we move forward. The information requires to be available to the authorized parties whenever required. Unavailability to data and systems can have serious consequences. It is also essential to have plans and procedures to prevent or mitigate data loss in case of a disaster. A disaster recovery plan must include unpredictable events such as natural disaster and fire. Security controls. Security controls are the parameters implemented to protect various forms of data and infrastructure important to an organization. It means any type of safeguard used to avoid, detect, counteract, or minimize security risks to physical property, information, computer systems, or other assets is considered as a security control. There are four types of security controls: physical security controls, digital security controls, cyber security controls, and cloud security controls. Now, let us look into the four types of security controls with examples. The controls are designed for the protection of a personal, hardware, software, networks, and data from physical actions and incidents that could cause serious loss or damage to an individual or an organization is said to be as physical security controls. Examples: physical logs, biometric access control systems, access control cards. You could be using or seeing the employees of an organization is provided with access cards to enter into their office. The controls designed for the protection or securing your identity, assets, and technology in the online and mobile world is said to be as digital security controls. Examples: username and passwords, antivirus software, multi-factor authentication. Any mobile or computer uses the password to allow the user to log in or use. When we are trying to make an online transaction, our banking website or mobile application asks for OTP as an additional security measure. Control measures that a business deploys to manage the online threats that are targeting computer systems and networks is said to be as cyber security controls. Examples: unauthorized hardware and software, data leakage protection, and anti-malware defenses. All the hardware and software that requires access to the network should be listed down, validated, and then allowed to connect to the network. Anti-malware software detects and blocks the malware that is trying to enter into the computer. Cloud security controls consist of all the measures, practices, and guidelines that must be implemented to protect the cloud computing environment. Examples: traffic analysis, alerts for configuration issues. Misconfiguration of cloud security controls very well leave the gaps for which cyber criminals are waiting for. To minimize the risks, security teams need centralized visibility into their cloud infrastructure. Tools like cloud workload protection could help to integrate cloud management and security systems. Information assets and asset owner. Any data, device, or other component of the environment that has a value to an individual or an organization is said to be as information asset. Example: data about customers and prospective customers, financial data, and trade secrets. Information asset owner ensures all the information assets are properly protected and their value to the organization is fully utilized. Server owner and application owner are the examples of information asset owners. They hold the sole responsibility for the assigned server or application in all the aspects like accountability, security, etc. Let us look at cybersecurity threats. What is a cybersecurity threat? The possibility of an unkind attempt to damage or disrupt a computer system, network, files, or digital life in general. There are a lot many channels they come from. To name a few: terrorists, hackers, business competitors, frustrated insiders, organized crime groups, and accidental actions of authorized users. Let us look into this in detail when we move forward. These are the few examples for cybersecurity threats. We will learn more about the various types of cybersecurity threats and remedy in detail. We'll add up one example or scenario to understand better about each threats. Let us learn about hackers and predators and their difference. Who is a hacker? Hacker is an unauthorized user who breaks into computer systems in order to steal, change, or destroy information, often by installing dangerous malware without the knowledge or consent of the user. Who is a predator? Predator is the one who harasses others for their own gain. This means predator is same as hacker, but he harasses for their personal gain. Hacker is like a thief who enters into the place and robs the material, whereas predator is blackmailing to make money. So what they can do? They hijack the usernames and passwords with which they could misuse the same for their personal gain. They may steal money, obviously, open the bank accounts and credit card information of other person also, makes purchases with the stolen cards and bank details, They may also sell the hacked information to other third parties, who may in turn use the same for criminal or illegal purposes. So how we can safeguard our computer and data from such hackers and predators? Increase the browser security settings, avoid suspicious websites, and allow access only trusted websites. Do not open messages from unknown senders. Immediately delete messages if you suspect that is a spam. Use antivirus protection. Get anti-spyware software protection also. Let us look at what is a malware, spyware, and ransomware. Also about the impact and its remediation. Malware is a malicious software and it shows no symptom to the user that it is installed. Without user's knowledge, this gains access to personal information or damages the device. It is like a COVID virus. People do not know when or how it entered into their body, but will come to know only when they get affected. Same way, we won't come to know when the malware got installed and how it got installed, but we'll come to know only when we see the after effect of it. So what is its impact? Performance problems like computer is running slowly or crashing frequently. Unexplained PC behavior. Interruptions like pop-ups and spam. Stealing of data, credentials, and payment information. What is the remedy? Regularly clear unused files of the computer. Backup all the files and operating system regularly. Be sure what we are clicking on. What is a spyware? This is another type of malware. What is the impact? This targets the browsing data, login credentials, or other personal information, sometimes with the purpose of sending it to the third party. This is like keeping a camera like another eye of yours. It records all the activities, saves, and sends it to another person, obviously the hacker. Quite interesting, right? So what could be the result? The person who got those information could make use of it for any illegal or criminal activity. Now let us look into the remedy measure for the spyware. Do not open emails from unknown senders. That is, when you are getting mails from unknown sender, you may mark it as spam. Do not download files from untrustworthy sources. Do not click on pop-up advertisements. Use reputed antivirus software so that any unsolicited downloads could be taken care of, and this blocks pop-up advertisements also. Ransomware is also another type of malware, and it is designed to block access to the computer system. This encrypts the files and holds them hostage until a sum of money is paid. What is its impact? Temporarily or permanent loss of company's data. Complete shutdown of company's operations and its associated financial losses. Financial loss associated with remediation efforts also. Damage to company's reputation. Example, COVIDLock ransomware. COVIDLock ransomware infects the victims through malicious files, promising them to offer more information about the disease. The problem is that once installed, this encrypts data from Android devices and denies data access to the victims. To grant access, victims must pay a ransom of $100 per device. so bad, you know. So let us look at what is the remedy. Ensure regular automated backups. Perform complete system backups. Protect the backups taken. And ensure minimum of one offline backup. So even if it is attacked by ransomware, we could get our data back from the backups. Here, let us look at another two types of cyber threats, keyloggers and Trojan horse. So what is a keylogger? It is a spyware that secretly records every keystroke and sends the information to malicious users using the internet. This could be anything. For example, whatever you type using the keyboard over mail, login pages, etc. This often steals the login credentials or payment information. This is like keeping a carbon paper while filling the application form. Whatever you write, it makes the same copy in the paper down to it, right? The same way, whatever you type is recorded and sends it to the attacker. And obviously, those details could be used on his convenience and wish. So what is the remedy for keyloggers? Use a two-step verification. Install software updates. Use key encryption software. Avoid downloading crack software. Obviously, always use the licensed one. Install anti-malware program. The best way to remediate the keylogger is using the two-step verification. It is like users will be verified twice with two different types of validation, like password and OTP or password and a fingerprint, like that. Trojan horse is installed through Trojan virus. Trojan horse could be remediated by not clicking on any advertisements from unknown or unfamiliar sources. Beware of false buttons or pop-ups that appear. Use an up-to-date web browser designed to protect against spyware. Use reputed antivirus software. What is a bot and botnet? Bot, in short, robot, is a type of software application or script that performs automated tasks on command. Bad bots perform malicious activities that allows the attacker to remotely take control over an affected computer. The collection of internet connected devices that are affected and controlled by a bot is said to be as botnet. What are the impacts of bot and botnet? Steals financial and personal information, attacks legitimate web services, extract money from victims, make money from zombie and botnet systems. How to remediate the bot and botnets? Strong user authentication method. Set your antivirus and anti-spyware programs to update automatically. Routinely check for browser and operating system updates and patches. Only click internet links or open emails if you trust the source. This is one of the interesting attacks in cybersecurity threats. DDoS, distributed denial of service. Seeing the image, you could understand the concept very easily. The attacker is sending his request to a controller, and this controller sends request to many number of zombies. Numerous zombies in turn attack the victim and overload the system, which in turn impacts the genuine request being fulfilled. Now let us look into the definition. DDoS disrupts the computer network by flooding unnecessary requests from numerous sources to overload the system and prevent the genuine request being fulfilled. So what is the impact? Cut off the genuine users from a server or network resource. Make websites unavailable. Data breach. Cost of mitigation could be high. Now comes the remedy. Activate website application firewall protection. Configure your network hardware against DDoS attacks. Deploy anti-DDoS hardware and software modules. Protect your DNS servers. Now, image spam. It is a junk mail which is delivered by fooling spam filters in the form of a GIF or JPEG image. For example, user will get the mail with the subject as "Dear PayPal user," something like that. It means it generalizes the target victim to get the attention using the image or a generic term so as to gain the confidence of the victim. Let us look at the impact and remedy. Unwanted newsletters, chain forwards, coupons, and adult contents, which makes you to annoy for no reason. Remedy: avoid opening such spam emails and clicking the links in the spam messages. Do not buy from the spammer. Do not tempt it to reply. Use a disposable email address if you are making any online purchases and all, you know. Not necessary to use your personal email ID for all such. Phishing is one of the often used terms, an important one when we talk about cybersecurity. Let us look into what is phishing and obviously impact and its remedy. A fraudulent attempt to obtain sensitive information like usernames, passwords, and credit card details by hiding oneself as trustworthy. Popular example is during this corona pandemic season, you know, users were sent with email with the subject as COVID-19 update along with a URL to click and open the document. Obviously, it is not a genuine link to get any update, but the phishing attempt to gain the access to the computer or our devices. Now let us look into the impact of phishing. Negative impacts with respect to reputation: hijacking the username and passwords. It may compromise on trade secrets, research, customer list, reservations and formulas and all. Loss of design, patents, even that may amount to millions or billions. Think before you click. Any of the link provided by unknown or suspicious sources, you know, we have to think. Installing an anti-phishing toolbar. Keep your browser up to date using the firewall. Be cautious about pop-ups. Any pop-ups you are coming to know. We have to be very, very careful before clicking. Never give out any of your personal information by any way. Use antivirus software. Obviously, needless to say, it should be a licensed one. Another interesting type of cybersecurity threat is phishing. Now look at the image. The client is typing the website where key wants to visit. The request is sent to the DNS server, but the DNS server was already injected by fake DNS entries by the attacker, which makes the client to visit fake website. This type of experience we might have experienced already. Now, let us look at what exactly is the impact of forming. Sends the user to a fake website defined by the attacker. That is, the attacker decides the website what the user have to visit. New posts and messages in social media that was not really made. So lot many surprises about the post which we have not done really. Friends request in social media that was not sent basically. New programs in our system which we have not installed. Often targets unprotected routers. Those provides free public Wi-Fi. So in general, we used to say avoid using the free Wi-Fi connection from malls, airports, and railway station and all. Now comes the remedy. Change passwords in regular intervals. Use strong and unique password for each online accounts. Step up your security by adding two-factor or multi-factor authentication wherever possible and available. Hope we have discussed already on this. Delete any suspicious programs which was installed unknowingly. Run an antivirus scan and remove any malware it detects. Obviously, again and again, we are reiterating it should be a licensed one. Keep computer updated. I mean, computer OS updates, software updates, whatever released by the manufacturer, we have to keep it updated. Spam. This is one of the quite common cybersecurity threats that every email user is facing. Unwanted email messages sent by the senders we don't know to sell a product or services to a large number of customers. Usually commercial in nature and not malicious. Prayer chain forwards, coupons, asking for donations, and unwanted newsletters. Misleading messages from the people you know whose email accounts are hacked. Sometime before I got a mail saying that I won a lottery and they asked me to pay a sum of rupees, some 14,000. As a processing fee to get the lottery amount to credit to my bank account. Even there are some news like people send the money and waiting for the money, that price money to get credited. Do you think it is possible? Sorry. We have to be logical. Do not open it. Do not give your personal information. Mark it as spam. Filter it from your inbox. Social hacking. It's exploiting human nature than technology. Cyber criminals uses a wide array of tactics to obtain secret information, gain access to physical and digital assets, install malware, or convince their victims to perform dangerous actions. For example, knowing that you have a bank account in a particular national bank, the cyber criminal might call as the manager of the particular bank and ask for the confidential information like your card and OTP to change something like that. There are also cases like people shared the same and lost their money. What are the impacts? Leakage of security badges or keys to the building or computer room. exposure of private and confidential employee information, frankness of customer list and sales prospects to the competitors. Remedies: security awareness training to recognize phishing attempts, think or consult before acting on urgent messages, and strictly follow security protocols. Avoid sharing personal or company information through social media and other public channels. Keep information private and secure. Next cybersecurity threat is unpatched software. Weaknesses in a program or code that a company is aware of and not willing to fix or cannot fix. For example, if someone leaves his motorbike or car along with their key, it is easy for anyone who knows driving to take and go. The same way, it is possible for a less experienced professional also sometimes to break through the system. Impacts: legal charges from violation of sensitive records, loss of revenue from system outages and decrease of production, theft of organizational assets. Remedies: automate updates, avoid free or low quality software, use a recent and high quality antivirus software, so any automatic update will happen without anyone's intervention. Use real-time data feeds, which enables you to block traffic to known malicious sites. Remove any software that is no longer supported by the developer, because the vulnerabilities will not be addressed. This is also another interesting cybersecurity threat: eavesdropping. Theft of information when it is transmitted over a network by a computer, smartphone or any other internet connected devices. Seeing the above, you could understand very easily. A message is sent from source to destination. If eavesdrop attack happens, it leaves a copy to the attacker. It is like while writing a mail or any message to your friend, sending the copy automatically to the attacker. Not only mail, anything we do, sending the same data or information to the attacker puts the source person in risk in many ways. Impacts: loss of privacy, because whatever you write, whatever you send, automatically the attacker is getting a copy of it. Identity theft, financial losses. Remedies: encryption of data, because even if the attacker is getting the copy of the data, it may not be possible for him to decrypt and read the data. Avoid public Wi-Fi networks in general. Keep your antivirus software updated. Use very strong passwords. The next section is about mitigating the cybersecurity risks and protection of our valuable data. What is cybersecurity risk? As per definition, cybersecurity risk is the chance of exposure or loss resulting from a cyber attack or data violation in any organization. For example, when there is a rain, if we go out, it is quite obvious that we will get wet. The same way, when our system is connected to internet, the probability or possibility of getting affected by the already discussed cybersecurity threats are very high. In this section, let us look into the various ways of mitigating the risk and protecting our data. Also, please remember, mitigation is minimizing the risk and not 100% remedy against the threats. How to mitigate? Following are the few ways. To move on, we will discuss in detail with examples, obviously, wherever possible. Keep software up to date, install antivirus protection software, backup critical data, educate your employees, cybersecurity policies for the employees, outsourcing key cybersecurity functions, securing the infrastructure, implementation of MFA or multi-factor authentication or two-factor authentication, identify threats, plan, and learn from mistakes. The very basic and fundamental step in mitigating the cybersecurity risk is keeping the software up to date. Let us look into the purpose, effectiveness, and steps involved in getting this installed. What is the purpose of keeping the software up to date? Patches are installed to repair the weaknesses or an error that is identified after the release of an application or a software. Newly released patches can fix a bug or a security flaw, can help to enhance the applications with new features and fix security weaknesses. Unpatched software can make the device a weak target. Patching a software as and when the patch is released is critical to deny malware access. What is the effectiveness of keeping the software up to date? Improved security, better performance of internet connected devices, fix bugs and error messages, repairing security holes that have been discovered, fixing or removing computer bugs. What are the steps involved to perform the software to keep up to date? Update vulnerability details from the vendors periodically. It could be fortnightly or monthly once based on the plan. Scan the enterprise network for vulnerability. Examine the vulnerability and identify the missing patches. Install the patches and validate. Generate the status report. Will the installation of the antivirus software mitigate the cybersecurity risks? Yes. Let us look into the purpose of installing the antivirus protection software and its effectiveness. Installation of antivirus protection software ensures systems are as safe as possible against virus outbreaks. If a virus signature is detected, the antivirus software will intercept and quarantine, preventing the virus spreading on to other systems. It is like our security guard in our apartment. The security guard intercepts and queries the visitors whether they are genuine. If suspicious, they are not allowed inside the apartment to enter. What are the effectiveness in installing antivirus protection software? Protection from viruses and their transmission. Block spam and advertisements. So you will be able to work without any disturbance or feel slowness in the system. Defense against hackers and data thieves. Ensures protection from removable devices. So data being copied from the removable devices are scanned before entering into the system. Protects our valuable data and files. Firewall protection from spyware and phishing attacks. Limit the access of websites to enhance web protection. Keeping an eye on kids or children using parental control mechanism. Protects the passwords. Backup critical data plays a main role in safe and smooth functioning of any organization. It is like keeping a photocopy of any important document like insurance, passport, we do in general. So in case if the original is missed, we can get a copy of the same without unnecessary tension. Logical, right? What is the purpose of picking backup of critical data. This creates backup copies of the systems, which could be rolled back in case of major accidents. Effectiveness, data loss prevention, because business could bounce back at the earliest with very less downtime. Operation plan B, obviously anytime can switch to the next option to move forward. Competitive gain against the competitors. Improved productivity because of less downtime of the systems. No wasted time. Peace of mind, obviously, needless to say. What are the ways to take backup? USB stick, external hard drive, network attached storage devices, cloud storage like Dropbox, printing as a hard copy in paper. Educating the employees plays a key role in mitigation of risk. In this session, let us see how educating is more effective in the mitigation of risk and steps to be followed to implement the same to get the best result. The purpose of educating about mitigation risk or risk is employers have the greatest impact in protecting the data and securing information systems. This also helps to protect themselves and the company, business, information assets against cyber attack. The effectiveness is the protection of company data, identification and report cybersecurity threats. Employees become aware of unexplained errors, spam content, and legitimate antivirus warnings. Awareness about contacting the right people to talk about the doubts in case of a cyber attack. So, what are the steps? Communicate the possible impact of a cyber incident on the business. Make the employee to understand that cybersecurity is everyone's responsibility. Hold regular cybersecurity sessions. Define and circulate rules for email, internet browsing, social networks, and mobile devices. Train employees to recognize and respond to a cyber attack. Implementation of cybersecurity policies in various levels gives greater impact in mitigation of risks. Let us also look into its effectiveness and various types of policy being implemented in the industry against such threats. Cybersecurity policies are the rules for the employees, consultants, partners, board members, and other users who access online applications, internet resources, send data over networks. This includes the requirements for antivirus software. This also includes security for the most sensitive or regulated data, or security to address the reasons of prior data violations. It is like following the traffic rules. If we have to respect and stop while red light is glowing, means we have to. The same way, if the policy recommends some procedure or method to follow, means all the employees should follow, failing which this may be treated as a violation and serious threat to organization's data. Often, CIO, Chief Information Officer, or CISO, Chief Information Security Officer, is primarily responsible for all the information security policies. Let's see the effectiveness of implementing cybersecurity policies. Business protection against various cybersecurity threats like malware, ransomware, phishing, social engineering, etc. We have seen already. Safety for data and networks. Avoidance of unapproved users. improves recovery time after a breach, safety for end users. These are some of the cybersecurity policies exist in the organization. This includes acceptable use policy, access control policy, change management policy, information security policy, incident response policy, steps for using work applications remotely, rules for using email encryption, guidelines on use of social media, business continuity plan, and disaster recovery policy. Outsourcing of key cybersecurity functions ensures flexible, cost-effective, and at the same time ensures the top-edge technology expertise support from the industry. The perfect example in our real-time scenario is getting the auditor's advice in deciding over the investments, tax filing, etc. We will ensure the safety of the money we have and to grow at the same time ensures abiding the loss of the land. Let us look into the purpose, effectiveness, and issues related to security in this section. Purpose of outsourcing key cybersecurity functions: considerable cost savings, advanced technology and skill sets, expert support, flexibility, and improved satisfaction. Effectiveness: trusted experts and professional analysis, round-the-clock support possible, bridges the skill gap, provide independent validation of security posture. There are also few security issues in outsourcing the key cybersecurity function. Sharing computer resources with other clients of the outsourcer, outsourcer's access to clients' data, determining ownership of data and programs, data retention, destruction, and backup. Securing the cyber infrastructure is a must in mitigating the cyber security risks. It is like living in a house peacefully, believing that the building and other facilities available are safe and secure. Let us look into the common problems in safeguarding the infrastructure and measures to be followed. What are the common problems in securing the cyber infrastructure? Outdated hardware, shortage of talents, security gaps since its design, increased number of devices connected, network protection, lack of training and awareness, greater number of cyber attacks. How to secure our cyber infrastructure? Have professionals to conduct an IT assessment, audit, and planning. Create and implement IT security policies. Implement a strong password policy. Periodical backup of data. Always keep antivirus software up to date. Update workstations, software, and firewall. Separate guest networks from the main network. Multi-factor authentication is one of the excellent methods to mitigate the cybersecurity risk. It is quite interesting. Let us get into the topic and know what is it, why we have to implement, and effectiveness, also how it works with examples. If there are only two parameters to validate, it is said to be as two-factor authentication. In general, if the validation is more than one, it is said to be as multi-factor authentication. Now, what is a MFA or multi-factor authentication? Multi-factor authentication is a security system that requires more than one way of verification from separate categories of permissions to verify the user's identity for a login or other transaction. MFA combines two or more independent credentials. What the user is, like biometric verification, what the user knows, password, PIN number, etc. What the user has, security token. Why we have to implement MFA, multi-factor authentication? Because it creates a different level of defense and make more difficult for an intruder to gain access to the target, such as a physical location, computing device, network, or database. Also, if one factor is broken, the attacker still has at least one more barrier to breach before successfully breaking into the target. In the past, MFA systems typically depend on two-factor authentication. Increasingly, vendors are using multi-factor to describe any authentication plan that requires more than one identity credential. Effectiveness. Increased organizational security blocks 99.9% of unauthorized login attempts. How it works? You log into your resource with your username and authenticate with your password. You will be questioned with an additional way, like OTP, security question selected in random, to authenticate that does not involve your password. Examples: text message verification, getting the SMS in registered mobile, authentication applications, Microsoft and Google authenticators have it, smart cards, USB keys. This comes under digital authentication keys, fingerprints, facial recognition, retina or iris scanning, answers to personal security questions. What are the tips to implement MFA, multi-factor authentication? Consider the parameters how you will deploy MFA within your organization. Consider enabling conditional access to control when multi-factor authentication is required. What are the types of MFA methods that is easier to work? Evaluate MFA security on a regular basis. Be safe and vigilant. Cyber hygiene is a must for a safe and secure lifestyle. Cyber security protects from external intruders who are stealing or snatching confidential information. It is interlinked with the safety of everyone, since most of our communication, money transaction, and other crucial data is online. In short, stay alert, stay vigilant, and be safe. These are few examples for our easy understanding. Safe browsing, email, online ticket booking, online banking or net banking, social media like WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, etc., digital wallets, online games, vigilant parenting, unauthorized Wi-Fi access. What are the steps to be followed and what is the way forward when something goes wrong? It is described in detail with best possible easy examples in this section. In this section, we talk about the list of safety measures to be followed while using the browser. It could be in laptop, desktop, tab, or even in mobile. So, what is a browser? It is an application or portal used to get access to the internet. An individual is exposed to various internet browsers. Though each browser is having some perceived and real benefits, none of them are safe from security threats. Let us discuss here about the common browser security threats and how to protect the system. First and foremost basic step is removal of the saved login credentials. Bookmark paired with saved login for the linked site is not advisable. It is like locking your car and keeping the key there itself. Cyber criminal can easily reset user IDs and profiles on almost every website we visit. Few websites use two-factor authentication like texting OTPs to mobile phones. So, it is advisable to prefer two-step authentication whenever and wherever possible and ensure the safety of your data. The remedy is, it is recommended not to save the credentials in the browser. Use password managers like PasswordSafe or KeePass to avoid the leakage of the password to the cyber criminals. Next is how to deal with the permission to the browser's history. It is a type of tracing mechanism of what we do in the browser and sites visited. Browser history tells the name of the sites we visited and for how long and when. Always there is a remedy for any problem. For this, deleting the browser cache to remove risky information, especially when engaged in confidential activities like online banking. This could be performed manually in the browser or set to automatic when closing the browser. When we use a public system, please ensure we are using incognito mode. Another browser security threat is cookies. It consists of stored local files and the links to certain files. Like browsing history, cookies can also trace what site was visited and obtain the credentials. Remedy is very simple. It is disabling the cookies. Getting rid of cookies on a regular basis can help you safeguard the browser to be careful of repetition of information by websites as a side effect. Browser cache stores the sections of website pages, which makes accessing and loading of the sites easier and quick every time we visit. Saves location and device discovery, which is the risky element as anyone can locate us and our device. So, the remedy is use incognito browsing and manually clear the cache as per the requirement, especially after a sensitive browser search. Browsers like Chrome and Firefox stores address information, profiles at times, and other personal information. The criminal is aware and informed about all your personal details. Remedy? disable the same if not required. Person who uses internet may not have his permanent residential address, but for sure will have a permanent mail ID to communicate in this digital world. Let us look at what is it, how it could be protected, what are the general measures to be followed to safeguard from the external threats. Short form of electronic mail or email is the data that is exchanged between two users over internet. Contains text, images, files, or other attachments to a specified email ID or group of email IDs. Email travels through several intermediaries, including several servers, internet service providers, email clients, with multiple copies of the message stored at each server in both the sender and recipient's computer. It is like traveling to our favorite holiday destination right from our doorstep. We use various commuting vehicles, right from auto, taxi for short distances, and train flights with few transfers in between. Also, we leave our transfer details and footages in all the places. How to protect password? Usage of same usernames and passwords for multiple accounts could result in breach of multiple accounts with a single hook. For example, keeping the same password in multiple accounts is like keeping a single key for your car, bike, and house. If one key is known to the criminal or exposed to the criminal, the possibility of accessing all the mentioned above is very well possible. Same way, keep separate password for separate accounts. Additionally, changing the password in scheduled duration also advisable to be more secure. Prefer choosing longer and stronger passwords. Relying on password alone is insecure. Enabling two-factor authentication is preferred through an app or mobile application. If it is through SMS, it is also possible to fall as a victim to SIM card spoofing. By keeping two-factor or multi-factor authentication, the system gives additional protection in safeguarding our data. What are the general measures? Always confirm that the reply is sent to the genuine email address and not to spam address. When responding to a group email, correctly choose whether you are going to reply to the sender or reply to all in the group mails. Email encryption. Best strategy to keep your email private is to encrypt it directly. Gmail and Microsoft provides encryption option. It is known that world's largest employer, Indian Railways subsidiary IRCTC, books 13 lakh online tickets per day. Also, it is capable of booking 15,000 tickets per minute and can handle 3 lakh concurrent users. Obviously, our personal and financial data is traveling through many intermediaries. The same way, air travel, hotel bookings also. Let us look into what are all the threats pertaining to online ticket booking and precaution measures what we have to do in this session. What is online ticket booking? An e-ticket is the digital ticket. This term is commonly used for airline, railways, transport, and entertainment industries. Airfare, hotel, car rental comparison websites are an increasingly popular to book travel. Online travel aggregators use many search engines and third-party query tools to generate their own search results to find matching flights and car hotels rates. Few book reservations on behalf of the users, and they are responsible for credit card processing and underlying data security. What is the remedy? Go directly to the official website of the hotel, airline, or rental car agency to book the reservations. It should have HTTPS in the URL. If you are not sure you are on a real site, call the company directly to verify. If you have decided to use a third-party site, choose a well-known and reputed brand. Get recommendations for trusted travel companies or websites from your friends and family network. Use a credit card instead of a debit card to book online. In case the website is phony, you won't have given the cyber criminals direct access to your bank account. Many credit card companies offer fraud protection. After you make an online reservation, always call the company to confirm. If there is no record of your reservation, you will be able to alert your credit card company to report the fraud. Next comes online banking or net banking. Let us look at the list of secured ways on how to use online banking and about safety and security policies of the smartphone. What is online banking? Accessing bank account and carrying out financial transactions through the internet using smartphone, tablet, or computer. Online banking is quick, usually free, and allows to carry out several tasks such as paying bills and transferring money without having to visit or call bank. What are all the secured ways to use online banking? Check the bank statement often and report any suspicious activity. It means checking the bank statement in the bank's mobile app or bank's portal. Never access your online bank accounts through hyperlinks in emails, pop-up windows, or search engines. Be aware of unexpected hoaxes and scam emails with attachments, and be aware of suspicious websites. Always log out after using online banking session. It means no compromise by closing the window directly. Laziness on this could be realized later as very, very costly. Only use secured Wi-Fi connection. If public Wi-Fi is available, avoid using it and use only smartphone's mobile data connection. It means always avoid using the free Wi-Fi connection available in airport, railway station, and malls. Install personal firewall and antivirus software. Also, update them regularly. Always keep operating system and antivirus up to date. Never leave your computer unattended. Change your password regularly. Every 2 months preferred. Choose very strong password and do not keep same password for different accounts. Let us look into the safety and security practices of smartphones use. Download official banking apps from the official app store of the mobile phone manufacturer. Anyone could become the victim of identity theft at any time, even if you routinely take steps to safeguard your personal information. Avoid clicking on suspicious links. One of the most common tactics of hackers and scammers is to send you a legitimate looking email that claims to be from the bank and asks to verify the identity or input the account information. Never get panic and respond to such emails. On top of everything, always keep your mobile phone and laptop safe with you and keep it locked. Social media helps everyone who wants to connect with people, develop and keep relationships. Obviously, knowingly or unknowingly, sharing the personal information in social media becomes a two-edged sword. Here, let us explore what are all the risks involved and how we have to be safe against those risks. Social media is a digital tool that allows users to quickly create and share content with the public. It includes a wide range of websites and applications. Needless to say, example as Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, Twitter, and for professional connection, it is LinkedIn. What are the risks involved with social media? Once posted, always posted. It means the content always exists. Though you delete the post, the server keeps a copy of it. Keep personal information as personal. What does it mean? When you are sharing personal information about your travel, it is known to all the members connected with you, which could be a threat to you directly or indirectly. It is like telling everyone that I am unavailable for the next 2 days or 2 weeks at my home means, do you think, is it safe to share? Other risks, passwords, permission and agreements, and friends. How to stay safe in social media? Use separate passwords for each social network. Watch your mailbox because you'll be getting alert mails, messages whenever there is an update or action in your social media user ID. Don't be too personal. Lock your phone, laptop, etc. Use the block button because if you smell something not correct, be cool. Block the person immediately. If it happens in a group, report immediately to the group admin or to the authorized provider whoever is responsible. Understand the difference between public and private because certain information could be shared as public if you are using social media for your business. Because in this scenario, network is the pillar of your business. But when it comes to private life, we have to learn to be very much stringent in sharing any information or data. Think twice before posting and tagging. Be vigilant about the visibility. Know what action to take when you are getting positive or negative response. Try to use two-factor authentication or multi-factor authentication whenever possible. Keep security software up to date. In this digital world, the quite common payment used is digital wallets. Carrying a physical wallet is not a must nowadays to make the payments. Mobile phone is used to transfer payment data securely. The digital wallets heavily encrypt all credit card and bank details to help keep them secure from hackers. Let us look at this in detail. What is a digital wallet? Digital wallet is an e-wallet or electronic wallet. It's a service that allows us to pay for any purchase or bill usually through a mobile phone app or application. It stores items such as driver's license, gift cards, and transportation passes. Not only easier, but also more secure than a traditional physical wallet. Example, Google Pay, Paytm, PhonePay. Yes, digital wallet is safe. Major digital wallet apps are widely believed to be safer than carrying your financial information and other confidential documents in your physical wallet. Digital wallet apps or application heavily encrypt their users' payment data, making it difficult to compromise when the information is being transferred from the application to the payment system. Yes, digital payments are not for everyone. Some are not happy using digital wallets, while few are concerned about data privacy. Depending on the wallet service, data may be stored by a third party and used for purposes not intended by the consumer. Few may also worry about loss of payment and personal data if your mobile device is hacked, lost, or stolen, or if your payment is sent to the wrong person. How we have to be safe and vigilant while playing online games. In this section, let us look at whether we can encourage online games, how to choose the online games, the risks involved, and also the safety measures to be followed while playing. Especially during this pandemic season, children are more frustrated to stay inside home 24/7. Obviously, they tend to play such games with their friends and relatives. So, what is online game? A video game that is played through the internet or any other computer network is said to be as online game. Can we encourage? Though online game is a form of entertainment, it could help children to develop their creativity, encourage relationships with friends, and improve strategic thinking with parents' guidance and support. How to choose good games? In other words, how we can select, how we can prefer. Read the reviews from other websites and not from the same website or the creator's website. Select the games what the entire family can play or enjoy. Check the ratings in App Store and the type of content to understand whether it is age appropriate. Play or watch to get the best understanding about the game features. What are the risks in online games? Being internet based, it is possible to download games with less reputed sites. This may end up in downloading spam, viruses, and malicious software, etc. Few finds way to take unnecessary advantage of the children. Children are fooled, cheated, abused, and harassed online. How to play online games safely? Keep your personal information always as secret, especially not to share it on the unknown sites. Online games require passwords to access. Never ever share and avoid cheating or getting hacked. Never give your personal or real names online unless the website has a good reputation. Never ever trust anyone whom you meet online. Never agree to meet them in person. Online gaming should be played only for fun. Avoid accessing age restricted activities like gambling. What are the additional safety measures? Install antivirus software and should be updated every day. This protects your computer from common viruses and it comes with parental guidance features, using which you can avoid entering illegal sites and unsafe sites. Activate the family safety settings manually, which blocks the sites which you do not want your children to enter. Limit their gaming privileges for few hours per day. Suggest and encourage them to play only the known safest games so that they do not browse for games on their own. Mobile safety. In this digital world, mobile phone is said to be as the sixth finger of any person who uses it. No doubt, but it has become the integral part of anyone's life now. Let us look at what are all the existing risks in using the mobile phone and the safety measures which we have to look into in this section. What is a mobile or smartphone? Portable telephone, which is used to make and receive calls. Also used in case of an emergency. Smartphones keep people connected with video calls and social networking apps or applications. This also functions as a handheld mobile computer for accessing and browsing the web. Stay up to date on breaking news and online shopping. What are all the risks in using the smartphone? While selecting, keep the security features as the top priority. Configure it to be more secure. Configure web accounts to use secured connections. Do not follow links sent through suspicious email or text messages. This means clicking the unknown links and suspicious mail may invite the malware to get installed. Hope you remember we have seen about malware in our previous sessions. Limit exposure of your mobile number. Carefully consider what information you want to store in the device. Be choosy when selecting and installing mobile apps or applications. This means nowadays a lot of mobile apps offers free cashback to increase their promotion. If you really want the app, carefully analyze the purpose and duration of usage and also check its security protocols. Maintain physical control of the device, especially in public or semi-public places. Disable interfaces that are not currently in use, such as Bluetooth, infrared, or Wi-Fi. Set Bluetooth-enabled devices to non-discoverable, failing which our mobile device could be easily traceable by anyone who scans for its existence and possible for the hacker or intruder to take control or install any malware. Avoid joining unknown Wi-Fi networks and using public Wi-Fi hotspots. Delete all the information stored in the device prior to discarding it. Be careful while using social network applications. Discard out-of-date devices. How to use our mobile phone safely? Set a PIN or password to lock the keypad and screen. Set up parental and emergency contacts. Keep mobile's operating system as up to date. Connect through secured Wi-Fi. Install and activate remote locate, lock, and wipe software. Install antivirus and anti-spyware software. Ensure secured downloads from the official app stores. Turn off location sharing. Turn off Bluetooth when not in use. Check your privacy and security settings. Put your password on wireless carrier account. Never store sensitive information on the phone. Parenting in digital age. This is one of the excellent and needed topics covered in this course. Parenting in this digital age is easy but not known to many. This is very much helpful to each and every parent who is allowing their child to use the smartphone, mobile, laptop or desktop. Information shared here for specific age segments. Ages between 9th to 12th, 13th to 17th and under 8 also. What is parenting? Children are always energetic, harder sometimes, and there are several techniques requires to be used to be a vigilant parent. When it is about technology, then it should be tackled with the help of technology. Digital parenting tips for the parents who is having children below 8. Sit with them when they are online. Learn and discuss together. Keep the computer, laptop, operating system up to date with the latest firewall, antivirus, anti-spyware software. If you have opted for parental controls and filters, maximize the features. Privacy settings should be at maximum levels on all the devices. Digital parenting tips for the parents who is having children between 9 and 12 years. Do not allow your children to go online whenever they want. This may bring more risks. Educate them what they do online, what they can visit and to whom they speak. Teach them not to share personally identifiable information. Educate them to how to block and report the people. Build trust so that if any wrong, your child will come to you and share the happenings. Digital parenting tips for the parents who is having children between 13 and 17 years. Encourage your child to talk to you about the problems, if any, in offline or online. Make an understanding and encourage proper balance and use of technology. Be aware of how your child interacts with technology. Are they tensed, angry, or cautious? Be prepared to help them and eventually seek support from other parents, school, or health professionals if required. Fantastic, isn't it? Awareness about cyberbullying and cyber harassment is one of the very much essential topic to be learned by each and everyone who uses internet. Though the government is having a separate cell or department for cyber crimes, number of cases with respect to cyberbullying and harassment is also on the rise and challenging. Now let us look at what is cyberbullying and cyber harassment and also its prevention. What is cyberbullying and harassment? Use of technology to harass, threaten, embarrass, or target young person. Cyberbullying is called as cyber harassment when an adult is the target. Examples of cyberbullying or harassment is posting rumors, threats or embarrassing information on social networking sites like Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, also sending text messages continuously as an individual or as a group. So what are the effects of cyberbullying or harassment? Constant state of upset or fear can lead to problems with sleep and hungry. Feeling scared, irritated or sad. If someone is already unhappy or nervous, this can make things much worse. Notable increase or decrease in the usage of mobile, laptop or tablet. Emotional responses like sadness, anger or happiness to the activities on their device. Avoid discussing on their online activities. Hiding the device screen when others are nearby. Sudden deactivation of their social media accounts or opening of new ones. How to prevent? Be educated. Always pause before you post. Never ever post when you are emotionally high or low. Never open messages from people you don't know. Speak to someone you trust. Keep evidence. Don't strike back. Tell the person to stop. Protect your accounts. Understand the range of cyberbullying. Avoid using public devices or computers. Also, do remember to log out if you used. These are all the general cybersecurity hygiene practices which was not covered in any of the specific category. Always check the sender's email address. What does it mean? If the sender is unknown, pay extra attention when reading the mail. And if you feel something not correct, delete it immediately and mark the email ID as spam. Always scan the shared drives before using them. It means the shared drive may contain any malware, trojans or any which may give unexpected surprises. Use common sense. Stay alert when browsing gaming forums and don't click anything fishy. Kindly remember, you cannot win a lottery in which you have not participated. Many of you might have come across like you won a lottery of £1 million from the public mail server mail ID. What we have to do? Simple. Ignore and mark the same as spam. Wherever available, use the virtual keyboard to type the passwords. Few banking websites provide the same. Use this for your safety. Do not trust random messages or those containing mistakes. If you have shared the financial details, call the bank or the credit card firm immediately to stop the payments. Do not give up on security settings of your laptop, desktop or tab, whatever, to increase the system's speed. Yes, safety is the topmost priority. Safety should be the first priority. Ensure the honesty of the source before downloading the games. Do not offer any confidential information to other players in the game. Be careful of the platforms before storing the credit card information for in-game payments. Here, let us learn about the business continuity planning and disaster recovery and its importance. What is a business continuity planning? It is creating the methods of prevention and recovery from possible risks to the company. What is the disaster recovery? Disaster recovery involves a set of policies, tools, and procedures to enable the retrieval or continuation of critical technology infrastructure and systems following a natural or artificial disaster. Why BCP and DR is so important? Because the cost of failure is huge and competition is powerful. Businesses might face huge financial loss apart from damage of name and brand value. Who could be impacted? Any company or organization, because they are vulnerable to various types of risks. This could be because of natural disasters, cyber attacks, and so on. Let us understand what is business continuity planning and threats to it. Also about the advantages of BCP and steps to build the BCP. BCP is creating the methods of prevention and recovery from possible risks to a company. What are the threats to BCP, business continuity planning? Global pandemics like corona, natural disasters like tsunami, cyclone, etc., utility outages like power disruption, cyber security threats. Hope we have discussed various types of cyber security threats earlier. What are the advantages of BCP? Business will feel more prepared to handle the unexpected situation. It is possible to work in remote locations when there is a need. Downtime is minimized. Continuity product and service excellence. What are the steps to build a BCP, business continuity planning? Conduct a BIA, in short, business impact analysis and risk assessment. Based on the business impact analysis, develop the recovery strategies. Identify the solutions that requires to be implemented for implementing the recovery strategies. Do testing the same and get the acceptance from the stakeholders. Routine maintenance. Initiate the business continuity program. Having a disaster recovery plan in place enables an organization to maintain or quickly resume mission critical functions following any disruption. Let us look into the importance of DR and steps to implement the same. Disaster recovery is the set of policies, tools, and procedures to enable the retrieval or continuation of critical technology infrastructure and systems following a natural or artificial disaster. What is the importance of disaster recovery? Why it is required? Protects the data against the after effects of natural or artificial disasters. It means any business or organization could bounce back to its original stage with less downtime after any natural or artificial disruptions. Reduces the effect of cyber attacks. Keeps data safe. What are the steps involved in building the disaster recovery? List down the inventory of hardware and software. Define the acceptance for downtime and data loss, technically speaking RTO and RPO. Recovery time objective and recovery point objective. Identify who is responsible for what. Identify the backup personnel. Develop a communication plan. Let the employees be aware where to go in case of an emergency and have an alternate work site. Make sure your SLA, service level agreement, includes disasters and emergencies. Ensure the details about handling of sensitive information are included. Test and update the plan periodically, the DR plan. Bouncing back or restoration of any business to its normal operation is possible only if all the record data is readily available. In this section, let us look into data backup, storage, and its restoration. Importance of backup, methods of backup, recovery steps, and backup devices. Data backup. Process of creating a copy of the data that is used for recovery in case of the original data is corrupted or lost. Also used to recover copies of older files if it was deleted knowingly or unknowingly. What is storage? The recording medium, electromagnetic, optical or silicon based, that is used to store the data. This is the key component of digital devices. What is restoration? The process of recovering inaccessible, lost, corrupted, damaged data from secondary storage, removable media or files when the data could not be accessed in a usual way. What is the importance of backup? Increased reliability, improved productivity, protects the reputation of an organization. Economic loss could be huge. Trust and obviously peace of mind. What are the methods of backup? Full backup, incremental backup, differential backup, and mirror backup. What are the recovery steps? Select the recovery module. Select the source disk or partition. Wait for the scanned data and files. Search and select the files you want to recover. Select the file storage location for saving the files. Wait for saving the selected file. These are the steps to recovery the data. What are the backup devices we use in general? USB stick, external hard drives, optical data storage, tape storage, network attached storage, and cloud storage. Since you all are very passionate in cybersecurity, listing down the highly demandable cybersecurity jobs available in the industry. Listing down few job roles with very high demand in cybersecurity. Information security crime investigator, penetration tester, cybersecurity analyst, cybersecurity consultant, cybersecurity engineer, cybersecurity manager, and cybersecurity administrator. Roles and responsibilities may vary based on the organization structure, may not be exact in real scenario. So you can take your time to pause and read the job responsibility